From the national headquarters of RT America in our nation's capital. Hello again, everybody. I'm Rick Sanchez. We have breaking news to bring you. We learned just moments ago here at RT America that the North Koreans have apparently fired off some type of what is being described as a tactical weapon. Let me read to you what is being reported now. They say it was actually supervised by North Korean leader Kim Jong-un, the firing of a new type of tactically guided weapon. According to some of the quotes that we're seeing, it says that after watching the power of the new type tactical guided weapon, the leader pointed out the national defense scientists and workers in the field industry performed another great work, quoting, another great work in increasing the country's defense capabilities. Now, we're not sure exactly what kind of new tactical weapon this is. We don't know if it's a missile of any kind. You're going to see, because we have a chance to show you some maps and some videos of other missiles in their tests that they have fired off in the past. We should mention that that doesn't mean that the one we're showing is necessarily what they're shooting off today. In fact, we don't know. We haven't seen any video yet, or do we believe that any of that video has come across showing this new weapon that the North Koreans are now saying that they have tested. Joining us now is Jim Jatras, a former diplomat, to try and bring us up to date, give us his reaction, his take on what's going on. You know, it's interesting. The Trump administration seemed to believe that they could rein this guy in. Does this seem to show, Jim, that in fact this guy has played this administration in the same form and fashion that he's played every other administration that preceded them?
Well, Rick, when I heard this report, the first thing that came to mind was that John Bolton and Mike Pompeo must be popping the champagne corks. Let's remember that there has been a lot of resistance within the administration to President Trump's outreach to North Korea, and really they don't want this deal to go through, because if there is a denuclearization in Korea, if there's an end to the Korean War, why do we have 29,000 troops in South Korea? Those boys and girls should be coming home. So I don't put this all on the North Korean side. I think there's a real problem within the administration as well.
These types of things by this particular leader, Kim Jong-un, are no different than what though his father and his grandfather would do. Don't they have a tendency, and should we see this as nothing more than some kind of provocation on their part? I used the term earlier, playing us. Isn't that indeed what they do?
I wouldn't say that, Rick. I don't see this as a provocation. Let's remember the failure of the second Trump-Kim summit, I think, was primarily from the American side to try to put demands on the North Koreans they knew would not be accepted, because they don't want this deal to go forward. I think they feel that their expectations from Trump are not being met, and this is their way of saying, hey, guys, listen, we're still serious about this.
Yeah, it's the old saber rattling that they seem to be really good at. And in this case, they're more pointed about it. Jim Jatras, we thank you, sir, for taking time to join us with this breaking story. For those of you who may have joined us late, the North Koreans have just announced that they have fired off a new type of tactical guided weapon. I'm Rick Sanchez. You found us on YouTube, and that's awesome. But you know what? I'm also live every night at 7 and 8 p.m. Eastern on DirecTV and Dish and cable and satellite, the RT app. Oh, and Pluto TV. I'll see you there.